In this video, we will discuss sperm transport, egg transport and fertilization. First, we will discuss sperm transport. Sperm production starts in seminiferous tubules of testes. Here, primordial germ cells undergo differentiation to form spermatogonium, which undergoes mitosis to form primary spermatocytes. Primary spermatocytes undergoes meiotic division 1 to form secondary spermatocyte, which further undergo meiotic division 2 to form spermatids. Spermatozoa then goes to epididymis. Epididymis has three parts: head, body and tail. In head of epididymis, first stage of maturation and fluid concentration occurs. In body of epididymis, maturation of sperm is completed. In tail of epididymis, sperms are stored. It also has muscle layer which helps in ejaculation. From epididymis, sperms go to vas deferens, then goes to ampulla. From ampulla, it is joined by seminal vesicle, prostate gland, Cowper's gland, and finally by urethra. After ejaculation, sperms are deposited in female genital tract. In female genital tract, sperms survive for 20 to 48 hours. Sperms then go to cervix, which acts as sperm reservoir, protect them from phagocytosis, filters defective and immobile sperms, and provides energy which sperms requires. Then sperms go to uterus, and by contractility of myometrium, they go forward. Then they reach oviducts, where by peristalsis and fluid currents, they are pushed forward. Now we will discuss process of fertilization. As sperms and ovum reach oviducts, they undergo fertilization, and the main site of fertilization is ampulla. Sperms first must develop capability to undergo fertilization. So, they undergo capacitation and acrosomal reaction to acquire this capability. First is capacitation. Capacitation is a period of conditioning in female genital tract and it lasts for 7 hours. This conditioning occurs in uterine tubes mainly and involves epithelial interactions between the sperm and mucosal surface of the tube. In this, a glycoprotein coat and seminal plasma proteins are removed from the plasma membrane that overlies the acrosomal region of the spermatozoa. This is the acrosomal region where capacitation occurs. It is important because only the capacitated sperms can pass through the corona cells surrounding the ovum. Then sperms undergo acrosomal reaction. It occurs after binding of sperms to zona pellucida. Acrosomal reaction has three phases: phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3. In phase 1, there occurs penetration of sperms into the corona radiata. All the sperms which are capacitated has the ability to undergo phase 1 of acrosomal reaction. In phase 2, sperms penetrates the zona pellucida, and in phase 3, sperms fuses with oocyte cell membrane. What happens in phase 2 is acrosomal enzymes like acrosin is released. It allows sperms to penetrate. Also, permeability of zona pellucida changes when head of the sperm comes in contact with oocyte surface. This contact results in release of lysosomal enzymes from the cortical granules. These granules are lining the cell membrane of oocyte. And these enzymes which are released from cortical granules, they have the properties of zona pellucida to prevent sperm penetration of other sperms and inactivate species specific receptor sites for spermatozoa and zona surface for other sperms. In phase 3, both head and tail of spermatozoan enter the cytoplasm of oocyte but plasma membrane is left behind on the oocyte surface. After this happens, egg responds in three ways. First is cortical and zonal reactions, which we discussed. Next is resumption of second meiotic division. The oocyte finishes its second meiotic division immediately after the entry of spermatozoon, and there is a release of second polar body and a definite oocyte. There is also metabolic activation of the egg. Then for fusion, male pronuclei swells and becomes indistinguishable from female pronuclei. Eventually they come in close contact with each other and fusion occurs. And this fertilization results in resumption of diploid number of chromosomes in the cell. That was all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching.